Today on the Justice Court, the plaintiff Ezechiedu Chidingozi is suing a friend Ifeanyi for the sum of 475,000 naira and the repossession of a car. The defendant Ifeanyi Ike is asking for more time to make payment.
All rise. Court in session. Honorable Judge Fumi Asalu presiding. Please be seated. Your Honor, this case is between Ivan and Ike. Parties one and both.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ngozi, can you tell me your full name?
Ezechiedu Chidingozi Ivan.
So you are suing Ifeanyi Ike?
Yeah.
For the possession of your Hyundai car. Can you tell me, narrate to me, what transpired between the two of you?
Well, my honor, Ifeanyi has always been a very good friend of mine. So for a while, he didn't have anything doing. Like, he was desperate looking for a job. Meanwhile, he's not educated. So he approached me and begged me that if I can, that he's looking for a link that can maybe buy a car, give him, and he will use it for taxi, which he will be remitting money to the person, like every end of the week. So I was like, okay, why don't I myself buy you the car and give you the car so you'll be remitting? Based on we are friends, this is something that friends do for each other. So he said, okay. January ending, I bought a car, that Hyundai. I gave him the car. Before then, we didn't sign any agreement because I just gave it to him based on friendship. He used the car for a week, going to 2 weeks. Meanwhile, he remitted 25K to me because we agreed on 25,000. The first week, he gave me the money.
25,000 naira weekly? Or
yes, weekly, yes.
Okay.
He remitted the first week. Then someone advised me that no matter what, business should always be business, that we should have a written agreement that will be signed by both parties so that if anything happens, I can have something to use and sue him or arrest him or anything. I said, okay, so I prepared an agreement which we signed. We signed it on 3rd of February. So that February, that first week of February too, he
gave me... That's this year, 2020.
Yes, yes, this year. So that first week of February too, he gave me another 25K. But from February 2nd week, all I keep hearing is stories upon stories. Like, since that time, nothing. Is it that he told me that Lasma carried him because he drove through one way, or he told me that police caught him, and arrested him, or he told me that family issues. Like, how can you be using my money to solve your family issues? This wasn't what we agreed on. So, I don't know. Okay, at a point, I was like, return my car. He said, car has been in the mechanic. That, I don't, give me money, no. Return my car, no. So, the other day, I saw him. I struggled with him. I was like, Oga, give me my car. Or give me my money. Like, we are going to the ATM. I'm collecting anything that I see.
He was driving the car?
Yeah. It was with the car. But meanwhile, he keeps telling me that the car is in the mechanic. Meanwhile, he's making money with my car. The car is not in any mechanic. So we struggled and struggled. He broke my two phones. My phones are here. But that's not even the issue. The issue is my car and my money because I can't lose both. According to him, he's still saying that the car is still in the mechanic, which I don't believe him.
So how much is the money?
Let's say about 475K.
Let's say about... 25,000 naira from when up till date?
He gave me for 2 weeks. He gave me for end of January and first week of February. So from that second week.
Second week February.
Yeah.
Till date. Okay. We'll calculate that. So can I have what you have to say to all this?
Your Honor, what she said is right.
Can I ask you a question? How long have you known each other?
It's been over 3 years now. before the business started.
So how did you meet each other?
We met on, we saw ourselves in a party. So I just woke up to her, speak with her like a sister because she was speaking the same language I speak. So from there, we get to know each other, exchange numbers.
And you became friends?
Yes, okay. Your Honor. Right.
So go ahead.
So the whole issue, what she said is right, though I myself have issues, family issue and all that, because at his, as he stands, I must say I'm like the breadwinner of the family. But I was pleading with her to give me some time. That I'm going to.
I want to ask you a question. You've been working with that car, apparently.
Yes,
it's just because you have family issue. Challenges.
And sometimes.
So the money you've been making, you have to be spending it.
And sometimes the car do break down.
The car do break down.
Yes, Your
Honor. For how long was the car out of work?
About 3 weeks now. Do up till now, he's still in the mechanic workshop.
Well, you know, this is not the first time you'll be telling her that the car is with the mechanic. Because the first time you told her, she saw you. Because that's where the genesis of all these issues is coming out from. Because she saw you driving the car. And even in the process, she claimed that you spoiled two of our phones while you were struggling with each other.
Yeah, not like we are struggling.
What happened?
I was pleading with her, but her phones was with her, on her hands. So when I was pleading, mistakenly, the thing fell off.
She dropped it herself?
No, mistakenly, my hand hit.
That's what I'm saying. Is that what really happened?
My phone was in my purse, so when I was struggling with him, the purse fell.
That was a struggle. Can you describe to me how, what happened and led to your reaching out with your hand and it fell?
We are dragging the car key.
Dragging? So you were not ready to hand over the key to her?
I was pleading while we were dragging.
You were pleading and struggling. And in the process, you spoiled her phone. And at the end of the day, because you are a man, she's a woman, she still could not obtain the key from you. That's what happened. If it's man to man, he probably would have been able to collect the key from your hand on that day, you know.
No, with the help of people that came to separate us.
Separate?
To settle the dragon. So they were able to talk to her.
Okay, so now, how much are you in now?
With my own calculation is about 400,000 because of the lockdown. We are not moving during the lockdown. So we are not going out. So those weeks, I was even explaining to her that the car is with me in the compound, that the car is not moving.
Okay, so for the period that the car moved, and you ought to have made return to her, you are claiming that you are owing her, you should have given her 400,000 naira.
Yes.
That's your own calculation. Okay. So, you were telling me about your family challenges. I'm eager to hear that.
Yeah, it's because of my father's health. He's aged and he's not working for now because of his health. So
if she didn't hand over the car to you, what would you have done towards the health of your dad?
I don't know.
I understand she's not your sibling.
No.
So I don't know why you want to pass that liability to her.
Not that I'm passing the liability. You I should just have wanted paid to her. Save the life.
You didn't make her a priority. That's her money. You agree?
Yes.
You agree it's her money?
Yes.
So how come you didn't give her money? Because at the time you were spending it, I'm sure... Did you even have any intention of returning her money?
Yes, I do.
In what way? What was your plan?
My plan was to save my father that was sick.
I'm not talking about that.
Yeah.
Are you the only child?
No, I'm not.
What I'm asking you is, at the time you spent that money, how did you intend to raise the money in order to pay her?
It's from my work driving the car, maybe Since I'm remitting 25K, maybe I might be remitting.
You should have 30. Agreed with her. You claimed, the two of you claimed that you were friends.
Yes, we were.
Before you went into this transaction together.
Yes.
As a friend, according to her, you affirmed that she merely assisted you because you had nothing ongoing. That's why she handed over the vehicle to you. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
Now, she gave the car to you. You entered a written agreement together. Do you have a copy of the written agreement?
Of course.
Okay, let me have it, please. You know what you signed? I'll read it out to you. I, Ike Ifeanyi, will be remitting the sum of 25,000 naira to Miss Ivan Ezechido. Ezechido, thanks. Every week. Any week I, Ike Ifeanyi, does not remit 25,000 naira to Miss Ezechido, the cash should be taken away from me. Only if I call Miss Ivan Ezechido to give a tangible reason why I didn't remit the amount, then Miss Ivan will pardon me. So it's at her discretion. And give me 2-3 days to pay up the money. That is your agreement. And 22 weeks. That's for the period between 2nd of February till date. In actual fact, it's actually 550,000 naira. But if you are to remove, you said for 3 weeks, it's been with the lockdown. Yes. You removed that 75,000 naira by your calculation.
The lockdown was 4 weeks, Your Honor.
Wait. Let me explain. She claimed 475,000 naira. You told me by your own calculation, it's 400,000 naira.
Yes, Your Honor.
That it ought to be. But I'm telling you now that non-payment of 22 weeks is 550,000 naira. And during the lockdown, she still saw you driving the vehicle around. That's the issue. So what were you doing? Working with the vehicle during the lockdown? The car should not even be out, should not be seen on the street. Because the government regulation at that period is of no movement. Am I correct or not?
Yes, Your Honor.
So what were you doing outside with the vehicle?
I was doing nearby, carrying people.
So you were working with the vehicle?
With small money to help myself.
Do you know the implication of what you have just said? That's an illegal act. Illegal act. You are not supposed to move around. Now you are taking a vehicle that does not belong to you. You took it out. And supposing they seized the vehicle, what would have been your story? You were carefree because it's not your sweat that you used to purchase the vehicle. Is that it? I'm asking you.
No, Your Honor.
So why would you do that? And now, the day you saw him with the vehicle moving around and you could not collect the key from him, what did you do? What step did you take thereafter?
Nothing. After the struggle, the phone breaking, he entered the car and he zoomed off. When he got home, he started trying to call me like, why are you calling me to tell me sorry? Benny, I need my money and my car. What's the sorry for you? Sorry, bring back my money. You're telling me I should give
you. Do you know where he resides?
I don't know, ma.
You don't know where he resides?
He doesn't stay one place. He leave here today, leave here next tomorrow. You know how they do.
So why did you take that risk?
We've been friends.
You've been friends? You are friends. And even when he made the money, you heard what he just said now. And he said he's not the only child for the parents, but he just decided to use your money to pick up the old bill. Right?
Yes, Your Honor.
To do big man, money that is not yours. I don't understand you. What point are you trying to prove? To whom?
The plaintiff, Ivan, said Ivan stopped making the 25,000 naira weekly return as agreed and started giving excuses. Either the car was faulty or he was arrested by law enforcement agents. The plaintiff, who is frustrated, wants to repossess a car. The defendant, Ifeanyi Ike, admitted it generated revenue from the Uber services, but rather than give the money to the plaintiff, he decided to pay his father's medical bill and rented an apartment for himself. Judge Fumi wades into this matter.
As for you, even though you had a written agreement, next time, make sure you get a guarantor to stand in for him. There will be a guarantor that will sign that if he doesn't come up with the money, he'll be right there to pay you. And you don't wait for so long before you even call the guarantor, because it wouldn't be nice to let the money accumulate very high before you let the guarantor know. The very first month he defaults, then you call the guarantor. And another step you could have taken, the day you saw him there, you can always engage policemen to retrieve your car, because you saw what he wrote there.
Ma, you can't arrest this one. He will run away.
What did you say?
You can't arrest him. He will run away.
What do you mean that you can't arrest him? So you took a risk. You are aware of the risk you are taking yourself, that you are dealing with somebody that is difficult for you to locate or pin down anytime you want to see.
It wasn't like that when we were friends. He wasn't like that. You know how friendship is. The person doesn't show you the real person that
he is. That's why you must take precaution. People change. People change. So tell me, how do you want to pay back?
I want, if she...
Where is the vehicle right now?
Is in the mechanic.
Which mechanic?
The bomber has issues, so I had to...
You're going to hand over that vehicle today. Now you have to think of how you are going to pay. Maybe you called your siblings to let them know that the money you spent to take care, it was ill.
Yes,
Is that what happened? How much did you spend on the medical bill?
It's close to 250,000.
So what happened to the balance?
I was using it for little upkeeping and other challenges I was having at home. Like she said then, I didn't tell her. I was homeless then. No, now the money that remaining, the remaining balance from the money I was meant to pay, I use it to get a room apartment where I can be.
I own money again.
My money.
You know, you are just lucky to walk in here from your house. Ordinarily, you'll be coming here from the police station. When do you want to start paying?
I want to be paying instrumentally. If she will allow me...
You are not having the car. Don't go there. You are not having that car. She already said she wants her car back. After struggling with her, spoiling her phone, on what basis do you expect her to still hand over the car to you? You still want to give him the car?
No.
I intend paying instrumentally if the car was with me. But since she is insisting I should return the car, I want to plead for her to give me some time. Maybe if, as I'm paying 25,000 naira per week, maybe I'll be paying 30,000 or 35,000 in order to meet up.
Do you agree?
No.
Said no.
I don't know what else to do. Maybe I'll go home. Maybe we could sell our land so I can pay.
There's no time for that. You suddenly realize that the same people that probably you deprived from contributing money for the medical bill, they'll probably be the one that will help you to make payments.
I didn't deprive them. It was because they don't have the money. That was why I did what I did.
That's why you decided to be dubious.
Not like I...
That's a dubious act. Act of dishonesty. Breach of trust. Is that how to repay a friend back? Somebody that assisted you? You didn't seek her permission. You could have asked her. If she allowed you to spend out of it, no problem. But you misappropriated the money. Now, and it's selfish of you, because you didn't consider the fact that she needs her money too. Don't you have an agreement?
We do.
Did you comply with the agreement? I'm asking you a question.
No, Your Honor.
So why?
I did it with the mindset of, let me save my daddy's life, then later I'll be paying her, because I know if I explain to her what I use the money for, she might...
The issue is, why I say you're a dubious person is because even the money you gave your dad is just 250,000 naira, according to you. The remaining 150,000 naira, instead of giving it to the owner, you spent it on yourself. That's why I say you are selfish. And that's not the way to repay a friend who has been nice to you. So, where is the car? Which mechanic's place?
Is at my area, because I stay at Ekotun.
You have his phone number?
No. But we live, the mechanic is close to where I stay.
Do you have anybody that you can call and we'll walk down? Because I want to call the mechanic right now.
No, people I know, they are not... No, today is Monday, so everybody went out for...
Everybody went what?
They went to market.
So they don't take their phone along when they are moving around. No, you're only fooling yourself. You are not fooling anybody in this courtroom. Ugozi, let me tell you. I'm going to make my own suggestion. He's jobless. The amount is high. The only way he is claiming he can pay back, which appears a bit, is to let him keep the car. But he's going to sign an undertaking with the court. You are going to bring two guarantors. Before you leave, you sign undertaking. You call guarantors that will come around. You sign for that. Then you work out in the undertaking, the terms will be stated there. Or now you'll be making the returns. You suggested 35,000 naira now instead of 25. Am I right?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is 35 okay by you?
Your Honor, I want 50.
50? About how much do they normally, the returns on... How much do they normally pay on a weekly basis?
Normally it's 25K if it's remitting every week. But if it's higher purchase, it's 30K.
Okay. So, but he's offering to pay 35 now instead of 25. Because you have to be realistic too. Do you understand me? If you're asking for a sum that I cannot raise immediately, it might be difficult for him to pay back the money.
Your Honor, if he can make it 40, that 35 is very small.
You heard that? 40. Because that means you'll be able to pay back on time.
Eva, please, I can't meet up to 40 because now most of the places that do give us work is still on lockdown. Clubs, school, other event places. And as it is now, the whole one day on, one day off is still affecting us. Please.
Well, Your Honor, if he can start with 35, whenever government decides that everything will be back
to normal, total lockdown,
he will do 40.
Yes. You've heard that, rather.
Yes, I do.
So you work it out that way.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So that means you start paying 35 from when?
From this week, because today is still Monday. I believe the car will be ready or will be out from the mechanic before the end of today, because I still have positive vibe that I can meet up with the 15,000.
Now, that's one. Where do you reside?
Ikoto.
You're going to leave your address. That's why you need two guarantors that will be checked out. Because you know another thing you took for granted. If he disappears with your car, how do you trace him? At the time you handed over the keys to him. So let him bring guarantors. So, two guarantors.
Judge Fumi helps both parties to reach amicable settlement. After the break, she wraps this matter.
The defendant is to pay the plaintiff the sum of 475,000 naira on weekly basis at the rate of 35,000 naira throughout the lockdown. And once the lockdown is lifted by the government, he will start paying the sum of 40,000 naira on weekly basis to the plaintiff until the total sum is fully paid. Secondly, the defendant is to sign an undertaking today with two people standing as guarantors for him to be able to continue to have possession of the car. Judgment for the plaintiff.
All rise.
Have you been cheated or have a dispute and want justice? Don't take laws into your hands. Log on to www.thejusticecourt.com and submit your case.